deflected that, and it went behind Johnson, and now we're going to get a fight as Turgeon, the Blues' leading scorer, got into one behind the net.
Of all people, Pierre Turgeon, and he was upset. I mean, he was just wailing away. I'm not even sure which Anaheim player that was, but whoever he was, he really landed a pop on Turgeon and knocked him right over backwards.
Boy,
Anaheim had come back with a good, Anaheim had come back with a good shift here, Gary, because that save on Havlin, it was a real psychological blow to Anaheim, but they come right back here, and it's still going on.
They have an injury here. Turgeon's getting up very slowly, and they've called for the trainer. It was Tony Herkus, who's already in the penalty box, who was pummeling away with Turgeon.
And it might have been Ruslan Soleil that popped him, but I'm telling you, Turgeon got knocked right over backwards by a haymaker right hand. It started all behind the net, and Turgeon, who normally doesn't get involved in the rough stuff, was obviously upset. Oh, it's Herkus that he gets the shot from behind. Okay, so it's Tony Herkus, and Herkus is the smaller of the two guys. But look at Turgeon. He started throwing it right away, and he got nailed, I think, with a punch from Herkus. Foot. When your goaltender is hot, you get saves like that from your goaltender. Tony Herkus, bang, bang. Down goes Turgeon, and Turgeon is still down.
Herkus in his 11th season in the National Hockey League has bounced around.
Throwing more and more punches. See, and look, it looks like he has all his faculties about him now. They're probably asking him what they... Now watch. Ooh, oh, baby.
Yeah.
Oh, that is a right cross to the jaw. No wonder he went down.
Bang,
right there. Look at Turgeon going down. And then the other haymaker goes right over top of the head. That's the one that I saw that I thought had dead.